All right, so today for Foundation Friday, I figured I would pop over to Instagram and have you guys just ask any random foundation, base-related, concealer techniques, like any kind of foundation-related questions that you wanted me to talk about, and we would just have like a chill chit-chat over here all about foundation. I know there's been a lot of new foundation launches recently. The Estee Lauder, I think it's called the Futurist, the CoverGirl Milk Foundation. I have like 4 new foundation launches. I just haven't been able to have a full day where I was feeling good enough to film, so I figured we would just do a sit-down one today, and then hopefully in these next coming weeks for Foundation Friday, I'll be able to do like a full day wear test and everything. Let's get into the questions. By the way, I did my brows different today, and I'm kind of feeling it. I just did them like super messy and just like brushed them up. I don't know. Undecided, but let me know what you guys think. It's always fun to just try something new, you know? Might look horrible, but I'm sure you'll let me know down below. All right, so I just screenshotted a bunch of things. Let's get into it. By the way, if you're excited for Foundation Friday and you enjoy while you're watching, you can give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, I upload every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 6 p.m. Pacific time. So the first question is, do you shave slash wax your facial hair? If so, do you find that it helps with application? Yes, I have a ton of peach fuzz on my face. I'm sure in certain Foundation Friday videos when I'm like real up close in natural lighting, zooming in, you can see it. I have a lot of peach fuzz. I'm very hairy. I have been using the Tinkle razors from Amazon. I'll link them down below to shave my face for maybe like 5 years now, a long time. I feel like I've mentioned that and I've like shown it in certain videos, but yes, I still shave my face. I still use them a lot. If I don't, I just have so much peach fuzz and it definitely changes the way makeup applies on top of it, which makes sense if you think about it. If you have like a liquid and there's some kind of like texture or something to grip onto, it just doesn't go over as smooth as if you don't have anything on your face and you just have like a smooth canvas. What is your preferred way of setting foundation without it looking cakey? What I have learned over the years from having oily skin, acne, and then going on Accutane, having severely dry skin. Accutane, I'm pretty sure, is like the driest your skin can possibly get. And then now being off Accutane and kind of having normal to dry skin and no acne anymore. So I've really gone through it like with different products and techniques and skin and everything. And what I've realized is that it's really so dependent on your skin, your situation, the products that you're using. Like, there's not one thing that's going to work for everyone. Products that used to work really well for me when I had oily skin and that looked like just super skin-like over acne, now they look really cakey on my skin. Try not setting your foundation. I think that's actually a way to make your foundation not look cakey. I almost never set the center of my face right here. If I set it with any kind of powder, usually it looks really cakey. I know now that there are certain areas on my face that I just can't powder. Anywhere else where I don't need to powder, I don't add powder. I know some people feel like they need to powder. Some people, it makes their makeup look more like airbrushed. And I definitely have a couple powders where I can see that. But for the most part, just day to day, I almost never powder my entire face. So I would say my preferred way of setting foundation is using a setting spray. There are setting sprays that are more long lasting, so it can help just keep your makeup stay on longer and looking good throughout the day. So my top product for that is the Makeup Forever Mist and Fix setting spray. I also love the Urban Decay All Nighter. Okay, there were a lot of comments about this. Makeup on my nose always looks dry and separates. No matte slash glowy primer works. I would say it might not be the primer, it might be the foundation you're using, because some foundations really don't stick on my nose and other ones I have no problem with it sticking. I've never been someone who had my foundation like really come off my nose throughout the day. I know some people that's like their kind of problem area is just getting like red on the nose throughout the day or having things not stick. So if that's you, then you probably need some kind of like gripping primer underneath. But also I would say make sure you're focusing on your skincare, because something I found actually in like the last month or so, when I had the surgery, I wasn't able to rub my nose at all, like in the shower and stuff. It was just really sore. So my nose was getting like super clogged up with just under the skin things. It was getting really dry. And then when I did try and wear foundation for the first time after that, it wasn't sticking on my nose. So maybe use some kind of either face mask or AHA or something where it's gonna clear up the area in the skin on your nose, because it might just be like that it's so textured or dry or flaky or something. And if you can solve that with skincare, then I'm sure then the makeup application will probably go better over top. Have you ever tried the Morphe concealer? I love it and have never heard an opinion from you on it. So I actually did a whole video during, I think it was during one of the 15 days of foundation, on the Morphe foundation and concealer. Both look horrible on me. I really am not a fan of both. But like what I always say, products work differently for different people. So I'm glad it works for you and you love it. For me, it looked like trash. Have you ever used just a powder foundation on your under eyes? I know that seems so bad. So I don't know if she means using a powder foundation to set your concealer or if she means not using concealer and just using powder foundation. I actually haven't done that second thing, I don't think I've only applied a powder foundation. As far as using powder foundation for under eyes to set concealer, I do that all the time. I feel like if you're someone who has issues with coverage underneath your eyes, using a powder foundation, if you can find one that doesn't make you crease more and look like cakey, can be a really good option because it just adds coverage. Like right now I have on the MAC Studio Fix powder in NW15. This is technically a powder foundation. This is what is on my under eyes right now to set the concealer. And I just like using something like this because it brightens under there and it adds some coverage. Do you ever touch up your base throughout the day, like if it's too shiny? So even when I had oily skin, I don't know, I think it's just like personal preference, but I never touched up my makeup throughout the day. I just don't like fussing with it. Like if it starts to look a little bit oily by like 4 p.m. or 5 p.m. or something, at that point I'm like, I'm only gonna have my makeup on for like a few more hours. So what's really the point? I've never been someone to like have a makeup bag on the go and touch up throughout the day. I just don't like fussing with it. I don't know. I still to this day don't. And especially now, I feel like I don't really need to as much because I'm not super oily. I think that's definitely more of a thing with oily skin. Of course, like the ideal situation is you find a combination of products that works for you so that you don't have to touch up throughout the day. The one thing I will do is like say I'm around a beauty sponge. It's not like I'm like carrying it in my purse or something. But if I'm like buy one throughout the day and I'm starting to get creasing on my upper lip, I'll just kind of like, you know, go like that. That's like the one thing I do to touch up. But as far as like applying more makeup, I almost never do that. What are your top three favorite sunscreens you like under your makeup or on their own? Okay, this one is easy for me. The La Roche-Posay, there's different versions of this one. So make sure if you are taking that recommendation and gonna purchase it, that you get the one I'm linking down below, because I've seen a few screenshots from people where they like got this based off your recommendation and it's the wrong one. And that always makes me so sad because I don't want you to not like a product because it's the wrong one, you know what I mean? But you're thinking that I recommend it, if that makes any sense. That happens a lot with like certain products, like the Revlon primer. A lot of you guys buy the white one. I'm like, no, it's the wrong one. That one, I would say if you have very dry skin and you like more of a thin consistency, get that one. I don't think that one's for oily skin at all. All of these, by the way, are hydrating and pretty glowy because that's what I like underneath my makeup. The Kate Somerville SPF that I mentioned in, I think it was November Raisin Rejects, I love that one. Like that's been, I think, my number one. I've just been reaching for that one over all the other ones lately. I think it's discontinued. You guys said in that video that you couldn't find it. So really hoping they bring that back. It's like the perfect consistency where it's just like creamy and moisturizing and glowy, but not oily at all and not greasy feeling. Also the CeraVe Hydrating SPF, but that one does have a white cast. So if that bothers you, then just know that it does. I don't really mind if I'm wearing foundation over top because it doesn't really matter. Also Paula's Choice, the glow, I forget exactly what it's called. I'm gonna link these down below. It's like in the pink tube. That one's amazing too. Super glowy. That one's the thickest consistency out of all of them. And I would say that one's also really good if you have super dry skin. So kind of along those lines, someone says, any good cheap moisturizers and primers for your base? And then someone else says, best intense moisturizer to start with to avoid dryness throughout the day. So I should clarify, I actually use my SPFs as my moisturizer before makeup. I don't use an SPF and a moisturizer because all those ones I just mentioned are super hydrating and they're basically like a two-in-one. I kind of think of them as moisturizers that happen to have SPF in them. So I've never felt like I needed to apply a moisturizer with an SPF when I'm using those because they just do the job. So out of all of those, the most affordable one I think is the CeraVe, but CeraVe also makes some really good just basic moisturizers as well. They're probably my favorite overall skincare brand where I'm like, if you're gonna need anything for your skin from the drugstore, go CeraVe. They're amazing. Their ingredients are good. As far as which one's the most intense moisturizer out of those four SPFs I just mentioned, not moisturizers, I would probably say the Paula's Choice is like the thickest one and it's kind of like the most rich feeling on your skin. Need recs for oily skin products, other YouTubers, etc. Okay, so as far as oily skin, I don't know if this person is newer here or not, but I do have hundreds of foundation videos and reviews and just videos on oily skin from when I had it for years. I have a whole video on best foundations for oily skin and powders and everything, so I'm gonna link that in the eye and down below. As far as other YouTubers, I would say Casey Holmes, she has oily skin. Product recommendations, definitely check out those videos I mentioned down below. What do you consider your undertone to be? What are your best shade matches? Okay, so I, years ago, had a different skin tone. Like my skin tone has definitely changed over the years. I used to be about 1 to 2 shades lighter than I am now, and I also had much more pink in my skin. Now I feel like whenever I wear a foundation that's more on like the neutral, almost like a little bit yellow, not yellow, but just a touch of yellow, mostly neutral with a touch of yellow. That seems to be the most flattering shade on my skin tone, but I feel like I can also kind of wear ones that have a little bit of a cooler undertone. So it just kind of depends. Overall, I would say neutral foundations look the best on me. Like, I love neutral, almost like grayish tones. CYO Lifeproof in 101 is still my closest shade match, I would say. But the Koki foundation in 10W or 10C is also a good match. Dermacol 208 is actually a little bit too light for me now, which is why I've stopped kind of including that one in shade swatches and stuff. But lately, I've also been going like a little bit darker, like half a shade darker, which I never used to do. I almost would rather be like a little bit on the darker side than the lighter side now, just so I don't look like quite as ghostly. I mean, obviously the goal is to have the same shade, but sometimes a little bit darker can look a little bit more flattering. What is the best way to cover standalone pimples? So when I had acne, I found that if I applied a concealer and a powder over the acne, like over the pimples, it would just lift it up and the redness would kind of come through. So I would always wear a full coverage foundation. And then if I felt like I needed like a little bit more coverage on certain ones, I would add a spot concealer. But for the most part, the foundations that I used were so opaque full coverage. Again, you can check out that video. I have a whole video on like extreme coverage foundations for covering acne that I almost never spot concealed. But if you are into spot concealing or you just have like a stubborn one that won't cover, I would say try not powdering it, like use a spot concealer, but then don't powder over top, and that might help. How do you avoid foundation rubbing off on chin / jawline? It really just depends on the foundation. There are very few foundations that I find are truly transfer proof. Too Faced Peach Perfect still, I think, is the best as far as it's pretty transfer resistant. Like hugging, putting white fabric against your face, like it's not gonna come off. The Urban Decay Stay Naked foundation, this one also pretty transfer proof. I don't like using this one on its own, but I do like layering it on top of other things. So that could kind of help if you have like a specific area that doesn't stay on your face well or that just transfers really easy. Then you could also only apply like the Too Faced Peach Perfect or something to those areas. It really depends on the foundation. If you have like a super slidey, like if we're thinking about like Maybelline Fit Me or something, the classic one, the more dewy one, not the matte one, that foundation is 100% going to transfer if you touch your face because it's super creamy. If you don't powder it, it's definitely going to like come off. So certain foundations, powder definitely does help. But if you're someone who's like powdering face and you feel like you're still getting a lot of transfer, then it's probably just the foundation. You can try finding a more like transfer proof foundation. Hot topic. How do you keep your concealer from creasing under your eyes? If you have lines under there, it's likely going to crease. I have lots of lines under my eyes. So do certain concealers emphasize it? Yes. Do certain powders emphasize it? Yes. But am I ever going to find anything that doesn't give me creasing? Probably not, because there are lines there, so product's going to settle into it. That's just a fact of life. I do think there are definitely certain powders and products that work better for creasing. Recently, I've actually discovered the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder, and this is amazing for creasing. If you're someone who usually creases a lot, normally I can't use loose powders underneath my eyes, but this one brightens and it has really helped with the creasing. I still get creasing, but I feel like my concealer and everything just lasts way better throughout the day. And I don't get as much creasing and my under eyes don't look like super dry. Someone says, not about foundation, but how did you feel about the Bachelor premiere? So by the time, when's this video going up? So the second episode, I think, will have aired by the time this video goes up, but in my time, only the premiere has aired. How did I feel? I friggin' love Hannah. That's how I feel. I think there's a lot that went on behind the scenes there with the producers and like getting her on and making her do that whole thing. I don't think she's going to end up on the show. I don't think they're going to end up together, but I just love Hannah and I hope she's the Bachelorette again. I feel like they might do that because people were so like gung-ho on Hannah in her season. Best tips and tricks for gals with pale skin, and do you have any recent white mixers that are good? Okay, so like I said, my skin tone a couple years ago used to be way lighter. So I have more videos from back then about just pale skin tips and tricks. I actually have a whole pale skin playlist down below, but I would say use white foundation mixers and don't be afraid to use products for what they're not intended for. Like years ago, I used to use a lavender concealer from NYX to lighten concealers because they didn't come in light enough shades. And they also didn't make white concealer mixers back then. Also mix powders. Powders are one of the things that I used to have a really hard time with, finding one that matched my skin tone. Do you have to set foundation all the time? How can you tell if you need to set it versus not? Okay, so we kind of touched on that earlier, but no, you definitely don't need to set your foundation all the time. But again, it depends on your skin type and everything. You don't need to do anything, you know? It's makeup. Like, that's one of the coolest things about makeup is that don't feel like you need to do anything. Sometimes you'll find things that work great for you that don't work for other people and vice versa. So just because you feel like everyone's telling you you need to powder your face or powder your under eyes or whatever, if it works for you to not do that, then don't do it. How can you tell if you need to set it versus not? Something I really like doing is targeted powdering. I just started making up that term. I don't think it's actually a term, but that's just what I call it, which is where I only powder in certain areas that looks good on my skin. And I think you can kind of tell, because if you apply a powder and then it makes your skin look cakier and just heavier and you just don't like how it looks and it looks worse throughout the day, then, you know, don't set it. I wanted like a super full coverage foundation today, so I'm wearing the Hourglass Vanish Seamless Liquid, and this one is so fussy. I have a whole review on this, but I'm literally like creasing every 2 seconds here. Love the coverage, but it is a very finicky foundation. I've talked about that in the past. Dry skin. I feel like setting powders still make me dry, creased, and dry patches. Yep, then don't use it. If you have dry skin, you really don't need to powder your face. Makeup usually lasts fine throughout the day, and use a setting spray. It'll give you the glow. It'll kind of like set everything down. Try not using powder. Any tips on how to keep foundation in place if you wear glasses? I actually have an old video on, and I did a ton of research for that video, so I'm gonna link that in the I and down below. But if you are a glasses wearer and need some foundation tips, I will link that down below. How do you fight against rubbing off your foundation on your nose when sick or if you have allergies? If it's like a temporary thing where you're sick and you know that you're gonna be like blowing your nose a ton for a few days, personally, I just don't wear foundation because no one wants to be sick and wearing foundation. But if you are like going to work and you feel like you need to be put together, I would say don't powder your face. Like, use a lighter coverage foundation and don't powder your face so that when you blow your nose and you take it off and you have it, you know, kind of like rubbed off right there, it's not as obvious on my skin. If I powder my face and I'm wearing like more coverage and everything and then blow my nose or like touch your face or anything like that, it's not as easy to kind of like rub back into your skin and make look like it blends. And it's not obvious that you have like a giant patch of foundation that's not there. Okay, so those are all of the foundation questions I'm gonna answer in today's video. Thank you to everyone who submitted those. There were a ton. So if you guys wanna see a part two of this or another video in a couple months or so where I'm doing another Q&A, let me know down below if you wanna see these coming. And if you have any more specific about like certain products or whatever it is, let me know down below. But I hope this video was helpful for you guys and you enjoyed it. If you did, you can give it a thumbs up. Makeup on the rest of my face. For eyes, I use the Lorac Diamond Luxe palette. Just in love with this thing. I've talked about it in my yearly favorites video. It's so good. My lips are Care Beauty Wifey with MAC Best of Me over top. This one's like super, super nude. Ooh, for highlight, I tried this Kylie Ice Me Out, and it is so pretty. Blush, I used ColourPop Frisky Business, and bronzer, I used my Makeup Forever foundation stick in R330. I did a foundation routine video recently where I talked about using this for bronzer. Have on a little bit of Midnight Cowboy just on my lower lash line for that glitter. But I love you guys. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.